This is my vision for our nation's future. A country where no one is held back and no one is left behind.
They took the hell out of that talk.
Do everything we can to address the challenges faced by everyday Australians.
But now that it's time to walk the hell out of that walk...
I'm not in a position to answer that, I don't know.
A report commissioned last year by the government for the government...
...to give this government important advice.
...now set to be ignored by said government.
But I'm just being realistic. There's a lot of demands on the budget.
Its Economic Inclusion Advisory Committee finding the current JobSeeker rate is so seriously inadequate that it's acting as a barrier to getting into the workforce, recommending a rise of 40% to just under $1,000 a fortnight. That's 90% of the aged pension.
Everyone knows that you cannot live on the level of income support in this country. Rent, bills, the cost of living is going up and up and up.
On the current $49.50 a day, JobSeekers report having to choose between medicine and electricity. Bill Shorten admitting it's not enough.
I couldn't live on it.
And yet...
The government gets it's tough, but we can only do what is affordable.
We hear a lot about the budget being tight, but across the country budgets are tight and people and families are making really tough decisions about what they prioritise. And I would argue at a time like this, the government should be prioritising people.
Independent Senator David Pocock, who pushed for the report, with some budget-busting tips for where to find the cash.
We've got $250 billion of statutory tax cuts coming down the line. Seems like a pretty good place to start.
We did invite Jim Chalmers, Katie Gallagher and Amanda Rishworth to join us tonight. They declined. Paulene is a Brisbane mum of two on JobSeeker. She's been good enough to join us. Paulene, thanks for being with us. What is it like trying to support yourself and your family on $50 a day?
It's a juggling act. It's robbing Peter to pay Paul. It's working out which days certain food banks can give out certain food. It really is mind confusing is probably the word for it. There's no brain capacity to think of anything else.
We just heard that some people are having to make a really tough decision between medicine and electricity. What decisions do you find yourself making?
For myself, a lot of it is, do I eat a meal or do I just grab a sandwich? So I have a part-time, I have a casual job to make sure that the kids are fed and that I have enough petrol to get to and from work.
And does it have much impact on the kids?
Yeah, it does, especially my daughter. She is 12 and she's homeschooled due to struggling with anxiety. And it can sometimes mean the difference between whether we can go to a social gathering for her to catch up with her homeschool friends or not.
So the proposal here is for an extra, I think it would be about $20 a day. What difference would that make?
It takes that slight bit of pressure off. For me, it would still mean that my power bill would still be on a payment plan. I would still have to watch what I spend money on. For me, it'd be that little bit of more freedom with petrol. That would be my biggest, that would be where it would go mainly for me. It would mean that on a Monday I don't knock back a shift from work because I can afford to get there before I get paid. It can mean that if she has a friend who wants to catch up on a Monday at a local park, I'll have the petrol to get her there. Mm. For me, it would be the freedom and the social side.
It's pretty perverse if you're not taking work because of the JobSeeker payment that you're on, preventing you from actually getting there because you can't afford the petrol. I mean, that says a lot, I think. When you heard, though, that this recommendation had been, I don't know if knocked back is the right word, but the government's not going to be proceeding with it, it looks like. What was your reaction?
Oh, sorry. I'm going to watch my words here. Let me be politically correct and say the government is not being very smart again. It proved to them over COVID, it's proved to them time and time again, when they increase the rate and they give people enough to live on, that the economy thrives and so do people, because they're not just surviving, they're actually having the chance to think about how that they can be more productive.
Paulene, the recommended raise would cost $24 billion, though. So does the government's explanation that it might not have enough in the budget make sense to you?
No, not at all. Not when you see some of the things that money is being spent on that are really unnecessary. You know, things like upgrading football stadiums. government needs to look at where they're spending money and why they're spending it there before they say, no, we can't afford to do it.
Pauline, the Prime Minister watches this program. What would your message be for Albo?
Come sit down with me. I tell you what, how about we swap households for a month? Mm. You then tell me you can't afford it.
What would you do with Kirribilli when you moved in, by the way?
Invite you guys over for a party.
Oh. I think we all just voted for that.
Yeah, yeah, I love the way you think, Pauline. Albo, that could work.
Albo's got his orders. Hey, thanks so much for speaking to us.
Thanks, guys.